Magandang gabi po, kapamilya. Many Filipinos took to the streets in different parts of the United States to join a global day of action against China and its so-called bullying of the Philippines and other Asian countries in the disputed West Philippine Sea. Balitang America's reporters are deployed in key cities all over the United States to listen to what these kababayans have to say. We begin in New York with Don Tagala filing this report.
A few dozen community leaders and members, mostly dressed in yellow collared shirts, gathered at the Dock Hamarch Gold Plaza across the UN headquarters in New York earlier today.
What do we want?
China!
When do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Led by US Pinoys for Good Governance National Chair Loida Nicolas, this peaceful global rally is a joint protest against China's oil rig installations in Vietnamese waters and the setting up of military base in the West Philippine Sea.
The issue now is China is getting more aggressive, taking really steps to build militarily in this island that they claim to be theirs, which is not really theirs.
The lesson for China is, do you want to be that sleeping dragon that's awake and put fire on all of your neighbors? You're not going to last long. Be the loving panda and bring everybody up as you rise up as a world power.
Protesters say going to war with China is not an option, but the diplomatic solution seems to be taking too long to resolve this issue.
Well, diplomacy has not yet really set in because not all the world has shown interest here. The world must be involved here.
While they came here to protest China's alleged intrusion and occupation in the West Philippine Sea, protesters say their yellow display of affection is an effort to show their support and loyalty to President Aquino.
As the president prepares for his State of the Nation address next week, he recently asked his supporters to wear the color of democracy, yellow. But critics say it was a move that could only further divide an already divided nation.
To show our support for the president, I still believe in his capacity as a president. And I still believe that he is following the vision of the mother, Cory Aquino.
Politics is always divisive. It's part of it. It's part of the game. We're into this. What is important is at the end of the day, we hold hands. That when we face China, which is the issue now, we are one and together.
Even if they say his rating went down, it's still the highest of all our presidents, including President Cory Aquino, in midterm.
Don Tagala, ABS-CBN News, New York.
Let us now move on to San Francisco, where protesters are talking about the rich natural resources that are being disputed in the West Philippine Sea. Romel Conclara joins us now via phone to tell us about it. Romel?
Jel, dozens of community leaders and members of the U.S. Pinoys for Good Governance gathered in front of the United Nations Plaza in San Francisco just before noon today to protest against China's claims in the West Philippine Sea. Now, what's being disputed are small islands that reportedly have large amounts of oil and natural gas. Recently, China has moved a massive oil rig away from the disputed areas, which may ease a tense standoff between China and other Asian countries in the area. But Beijing says they will not be stopped from carrying out exploration activities in waters they consider its own, regardless of what the rest of the world has to say. China has also hit the Philippines over extended oil drilling in the disputed territory. After the Philippines extended the permit of Form Energy, a Manny Pangilinan-led company, which conducts oil drilling in the West Philippine Sea. Back to you, Jel.
Maraming salamat sa iyo, Romel Conclara. And now we go to Los Angeles, where protesters are calling for a speedy diplomatic resolution to the territorial dispute between China and the Philippines. Steve Angeles joins us via phone with a story. Steve?
Jel, Filipinos are beginning to gather at the Chinese consulate in Los Angeles, ready to voice their opinions in the ongoing territorial dispute between the Philippines and China. For them, this is a countdown to the tribunal that will rule the rightful owner of the disputed territories in the West Philippine Sea, South China Sea. The Philippines is expected to give its opening arguments in July of 2015. China has yet to respond to the Philippines' 4,000-page memorial. However, lawyers believe that the tribunal will take place whether or not China participates. Activists believe China will not have any valid arguments if they do participate. While rulings aren't expected until 2016, community leaders say Filipinos must continue putting pressure on China, calling for them to join the tribunal. Jell,